The Secretary General is going on, he's heading to China for, I think, 5 days. Do you expect to be in touch with him? What would you like to see him do during this time period?
The Secretary General said to us when we met the Arab delegation with him just about 2 days ago, he was the one who said, let's remain in touch. Let's keep contact on this issue. And we will continue, you know, communicating with him and with his office, because he has a huge moral responsibility in looking after the rights of civilians, defending them against those who are threatening their lives, and in this case, the Israeli occupying authorities threatening the lives of thousands and tens of thousands of Palestinian civilians in the Gaza Strip and in other parts of the occupied territory.
It's very unfortunate that a few minutes ago,
one country out of 15 broke the silent proceeding, while the other 14 were ready to adopt this statement. This is very irresponsible, and it lacks sensitivity by the delegation of the United States of America, of not allowing a simple position by the Security Council in a statement, press statement, to be adopted, is in essence giving the occupying authority the green light to continue with their onslaught against the civilian population. This is very unfortunate. The Arab ambassadors, and I think that Ambassador Majid Abdelaziz from the League of Arab States will dwell more on that, will be meeting on the 12th, and he will tell you about some of the issues that they will consider. But I want to tell you here at the UN, we will keep all of our options open, and we will consider drafting whatever is needed to be considered by different parts of the United Nations. We will keep knocking on the door of the Security Council to shoulder its responsibility, and we know that there are other parts of the United Nations that can also come into play, and the Secretary General also has a role to play, and we will keep contacting all of them so that they can step up to the plate and stop this massacre against the Palestinian civilian population in the occupied territory, especially those in the Gaza Strip. Thank you again for, you know, meeting with us. You came at 3 o'clock and you listened to the Ambassador of Kuwait and myself and the Ambassador of the League of Arab States about what we hoped that it would be adopted as a press statement. Unfortunately, now, close to 6 p.m., one country broke the silent proceeding and stopped the Security Council from shouldering its responsibility. I believe that my brother, Majid Abdelaziz...
Ambassador, you mentioned other options. What other options are there? Could you elaborate on that, please?
Well, we have other options, including, you know, something to be done more officially in the Security Council. That is one option. Doing something in the Council of Human Rights is another option. Doing something in the General Assembly is another option. We have options before us, and also the Secretary General has options available to him. And, you know, these we will keep follow up on all these options, because we will not accept that this is the end of the exercise. We tried to make it the end last Friday. One country blocked the effort of the Security Council. We tried again today, led by our brother, the Ambassador of Kuwait, the Arab representative in the Security Council, and others in the Security Council. We are grateful for the 14 other members who are willing and ready to, you know, to adopt a press statement that would allow for, among other things, for an independent investigation by the Secretary General to be authorized to do so to happen. We will not give up. We will continue knocking on doors, and we hope that we do not face you again next Friday with other ideas and other requests, but we are keeping all of our options open, and the Palestinian people are determined to continue demonstrating peacefully and resisting occupation peacefully, and to uphold international law and to defend their rights, all of them, the right to end the occupation, to exercise self-determination, and the right to return to their homes and properties as in the basis of international law and relevant UN resolutions, including 194.
From our side, in the League of Arab States, we regret really deeply the failure of the Security Council to shoulder its responsibilities in this particular massacre that happened to the Palestinian people and the massacre before. And we were not coming with the maximum demand from the Security Council. We were coming only to ask for a press statement. We were not asking for a presidential statement or for a resolution to be adopted, but just a press statement to be to reflect the determination and the unity of the Security Council in condemning and in asking for independent and transparent investigation into those events and in putting everybody before their responsibilities in accordance with international law, international human rights law, and international humanitarian law at the same time. But regrettably, the Security Council has failed again due to one member against 14 members that have been invited. They have been in the past, whether it is on the issue of Jerusalem or whether it is on the issue of the former statement that was circulated last week. And the options, as were mentioned by Ambassador Mansour, came in the decision that was taken by the Council of the League of Arab States. And all these options are mentioned in that resolution that had been approved and which is going to be reviewed by our ministers on the 12th in their meetings in Riyadh to prepare for the next summit that is going to be convened on the 15th in Dammam, Saudi Arabia, as well. So that is, we will continue our communication with our leaders at the ministerial and summit level, and we keep all our options open with the United Nations, outside of the United Nations, and we will be pursuing the full and inherent right of the Palestinian people for self-determination and for expressing their views peacefully, unarmed people in the occupied Palestinian.
Ambassador, I just want to ask you one question about Arab League. Are all the members, can you say all the members of all the equally supporting the Palestinian position in this crisis in Gaza? Is Arab League united in support of Palestine?
Arab League is united. All the members met in the Council of the Arab League on the 3rd of this month, and there is a statement that is available on the Arab League without any reservation and without any footnote saying that there is a reservation from this or that country. So all Arab League countries are united in this particular situation regarding the incidents that happened on the 30th and the incidents that are happening today.
And the president, the chairman of the Arab group this month, is the ambassador of Tunisia, is the embodiment of showing the unity and the support of all Arab countries to this position of the Palestinian people and to the struggle of our people.
I have a question. We know now that the United States is the country. And I wonder why you're shy stating the fact that this is the United States.
I did. The Secretary General is going on. He's heading to China for, I think, 5 days. Do you expect to be in touch with him? What would you like to see him do during this time period?
The Secretary General said to us when we met the Arab delegation with him just about 2 days ago, he was the one who said, let's remain in touch. Let's keep contact on this issue. And we will continue, communicating with him and with his office, because he has a huge moral responsibility in looking after the rights of civilians, defending them against those who are threatening their lives, and in this case, the Israeli occupying authorities threatening the lives of thousands and tens of thousands of Palestinian civilians in the Gaza Strip and in other parts of the occupied territory.
Ambassador, do you expect the Security Council to convene another meeting?
I said all of our options are open. Tonight, you know, the Palestinian people and the Palestinian leadership is extremely disappointed because the Security Council did not, again, shoulder its responsibility, but that will not deter the Palestinian people from continuing to resist occupation, especially in peaceful methods, as it is happening in all parts of the occupied territory, including in the Gaza Strip, in a civilized way, in a respectable way. The violence is coming from the occupation. The killing is coming from them. The soldiers are not being put in a position of harm. Our people are being put in a position of harm because of the snipers, because of the heavy weaponry and soldiers from the Israeli side that led to the killing and injury of thousands of people. As I said before, the number of the killed Palestinians is 30 and increasing by the moment, and the number of injured exceeded 2,500 since last Friday.
30?
30. Well, I said that the ministers will meet on the 12th. They will discuss everything, and I think it's obvious that issues like Jerusalem, issues like, you know, the massacre against our people, particularly in the Gaza Strip, will be on the front burner of what they will discuss, and we expect that they will take appropriate decisions and will give instructions to all bodies that is related to the Arab groups everywhere, including in New York, to proceed with what they believe that it should take place. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And have a nice weekend.
Okay, here from the Security Council, we waited until the 6 o'clock deadline. Actually, to come back in, the guard said we need a minder, but that's how the UN rolls. The UN is corrupt, but we'll continue to cover the story. Innercitypress.com.